Buenos días, clase. Hoy vamos a explorar Colombia y Venezuela en nuestra clase corta. Son dos países que se encuentran en la parte noroeste de Sudamérica. Dos países muy grandes que tienen una población combinada de unos 70 millones de personas. Pues ustedes van a abrir los libros en la página 257. 257. Ustedes van a leer el texto y responder a las preguntas, ¿verdad o falso? So I want you to pause the video, go through the reading, and then we'll come back and look at it together. Muy bien, muy bien. Vamos a ir, ¿no? So we're going to go through the questions one by one. Los españoles buscaron el dorado en lo que hoy es Venezuela. Pues habla sobre. Ay, 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 qué tonto. Habla sobre el dorado aquí. Ay, ay, ay. Sorry, guys. This pen just isn't working for me. Draw. Highlighter. Let's erase this first. There we go, highlighter. El Dorado menciona, pero bajo Colombia, bajo Colombia. Por eso aquí vamos a poner falso, que los españoles buscaron el Dorado en lo que hoy es Colombia, no Venezuela. Eventualmente encontraron la ciudad de oro. Du-du-du. Pero no había aquí, no había una ciudad, ninguna ciudad de oro. They never found El Dorado, of course, right? That was always a legend which kept them searching further and further into the Amazon jungle, but they never found it. Pues esta pregunta es falso. El vallenato es un estilo de música con origen colombiana. A ver, el vallenato. Du, du, du. La cumbia y el vallenato son ritmos musicales de origen colombiano. Muy bien, esto es verdad. El vallenato sí viene de Colombia. Colombia es el segundo país megadiverso en el mundo. Está aquí. Sí, es el segundo país megadiverso del mundo después de Brasil. Esto es verdad. And we discussed this a little bit when we talked about Ecuador and the Galapagos Islands. Megadiverse means it has more than, I think, 5,000 native species of plants and animals that are only found, endemic species, right, that are only found in that country. And there are only 13 megadiverse countries in the world. Colombia and Brazil and Ecuador and I think Peru are among them in South America. Pues bien, vamos a seguir, ¿no? El nombre Venezuela significa Venecia Grande. Vamos a ver. El nombre del país significa Pequeña Venecia, ¿no? So it doesn't mean Venecia Grande, it means Venecia Pequeña. Esto es falso. Muy bien. Venezuela cuenta con oro para su economía. ¿Dónde está? Tiene oro, pero oro negro. Oro negro. Black gold, petroleum, right? You guys have ever heard of the Beverly Hillbillies? It's probably way, way before your time. But the theme song was like, they struck black gold, Texas tea, petroleum, oil, right? So Venezuela has extremely large oil reserves, second or third largest in the world. When we hit an oil price crash, however, Venezuela suffers a lot because it depends so much on oil for its government revenue. And that's been a large part of the problem in Venezuela in recent years, which we're going to learn about in a future lesson. So esto es cuenta con oro, no con oro, pero con petróleo. Esto es falso. El metro de Caracas tiene 47 estaciones. 47 estaciones. Sí, esto es verdad. Muy bien. Venezuela ha trabajado para reducir la pobreza infantil al nivel global. ¿A dónde está? Oh, aquí está como una forma de reducir la pobreza, la exclusión de niños y jóvenes a decenas de países. So yes, they have work to do that. So that is true. Although with the crisis in Venezuela over the past few years, there's not a whole lot they can actually help with internationally because there are many children who are dying in Venezuela from lack of food, medical attention, etc. It's a very sad situation. We're going to learn more about that coming up. Muy bien. Pues aquí menciona el vallenato. El vallenato es un estilo de música que viene de Colombia, especialmente de la región del Caribe en Colombia, y una de las cantantes más conocidas es Fanny Lu. Y vamos a escuchar una canción de Fanny Lu que se llama No Te Pido Flores. And of course, for copyright reasons, I can't show you the whole song, so I'm going to show you a little clip, and then I want you to watch this on your own. You can find it on YouTube. One of the interesting things of this song is there's actually two different versions of the video. One is a little more, I would say, internationally commercial and marketable, while the other one is more locally flavored. And I'm going to link to both of them. And do listen to this song because you never know when a question about the lyrics or about the content or something else might pop up in an exam. Pues let's go to over here. And I'm only going to play about 30 seconds of this and then I'm going to play the other version.
Noches ya sin él, como antes de que fuera mío. Definitivo, yo no sé, una semana y será un mes. Que pasan días y me muero, suspira.
And that's it. That's all I can show, or I'm going to get knocked for copyright violations. So I'm going to go and find the other version right now, and we'll take a listen to that. Okay, class, here's the second version. Same song, but different video.
Noches ya sin él, como antes de que fuera mío. Definitivo, yo no sé, una semana y será un mes. Que pasan días y me muero, suspirando en el vacío. Y ya.
I'm going to pause that and I'm going to actually go ahead a little bit because it gets much more colorful. So the first part is very dark. She's wearing monotone and then it sort of switches and it's very colorful. So I'm going to put the links for both videos up there. So in the first video, it's kind of for our vision impaired members of our class. She's singing in sort of a swampy area. But it could be filmed pretty much anywhere. It's very, I don't know, like a video you'd see from here in the United States. The second one is very Colombian flavored. It's filmed in Zocalo, in one of the plazas in a city. Super colorful, very Caribbean sort of flavored, probably filmed in Barranquilla or one of the cities on the coast in Colombia. So listen to both of those there. If you click on the I in the upper right-hand corner, you'll see a link to both of those videos. And you never know, like I said, when a question may come up about the video, maybe about the lyrics, something along those lines. So, esto es todo. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Hasta mañana.